Well, hello, everybody. This is Fanae. I am with the infamous Trey Gang leader. What is that? What do you call yourself?
The CEO. That's
yeah.
All, you know me, CEO. Trey
Gang what?
Trey Gang bitch. Trey Gang bitch.
I get to kick out of him, man. I'm trying to tell you, we get together, we cut the hell up.
Y'all doing Pink Talk, live on Pink Talk.
Yeah, where are we at? We're the 24th floor on a Winston Tower in an open media lab. And Eric is the one producing it. He's such wonderful, y'all. Yeah, I'm telling you, if you ever want to start a podcast, it is possible. And Eric will walk you through it. And I appreciate him very much.
We in downtown Winston-Salem, you know what I mean? Winston Tower, man. Top floor.
So y'all see those
lovely view.
When y'all see those lights up there, y'all know it's Eric up here showing out.
Yeah. Make sure y'all support Eric too, man. Yeah, he definitely got a lot of fantastic things coming in the future, man.
Yes, we appreciate him so much.
Most definitely.
Okay, so what we're gonna get into it because he gonna start seeing Eric with that finger. Roll it up. All right, but anyway, we're gonna talk today about Nathaniel in his career, because I have been around him since like 2015. I've followed him, and he is very much a busy individual. Everybody thinks because he stays in Winston-Salem and y'all see him on social media all the time, he's not doing it. No, he stays busy all the time, and I appreciate him, because when I told everybody about this, it seemed like everybody was lagging, but Nathaniel be on it. I'm trying to tell you, he handles his business, and I appreciate it so much. So tell us a little bit about your new project coming out.
Well, you know, the new
since
project.
Since I get on CD.
Well, you know, I was just telling Eric that, you know, so off the camera, I was just telling Eric that, you know, I just released the album January the 1st, you know what I'm saying? The first unit's already moved, you know, I actually give my order tomorrow, you know what I'm saying? So I had to come up here, you know what
and
I'm saying?
And you did CDs, not digital.
Not digital.
But you would.
See, the only reason why I did it, CDs, is because I wanted to, you know what I'm saying, provide exclusivity. You know what I'm saying? I wanted my product to only be provided by one source. You get what I'm saying? And as I showed you with the streaming sales and stuff like that, like the artists ain't making no money off of streaming sales. You know what I'm saying? Like, they said like on a million streams, you make $690 on a million streams. So coming up as an independent artist and your streaming power of a million is almost impossible. You know what I'm saying? Especially if you ain't got Breakfast Club, all these media outlets that already give you, you know what I'm saying, these millions of views.
But everybody's so convinced that people don't buy CDs no more. They are convinced that everything is digital
exactly.
now. But honestly, somebody just gave me a CD the other day, and guess what? Listening to my CDs. I still buy CDs and original CDs, not the bootleg, but the originals.
Yeah. Hey, and it's crazy because, you know, and I even, it's a lot of people that I done sold my CDs to who didn't actually have CD players. Like,
really?
So now you see that the record company is in cahoots.